my colleague Dr. Chaudhary, Secretary Mr. Chibbar, Joint Secretary Mr. Bandopadhyay, and I see the DDG Mr. Mahesh. Dear friends, it is a pleasure to inaugurate the workshop on new initiative in the computerization of transport sector. Friends, I'm sure you will agree that the transportation and technology drive the nation. I'm glad to share that my ministry is taking the necessary steps to embrace the latest in technology and sync with the times. Couple of years back, we launched the Protel's Vahan Sarthi that provide IT-based solution for vehicle registration and licensing. Vahan is designated to automate vehicle registration, permits, taxes, fitness certificates, whereas Sarthi deals with issuance of driving license, learning license, conductor license to citizen, and licenses for driving school establishments. The idea behind these two portals is to ensure we get the registration of vehicles and data of driving license holder on one integrated national platform. Having the data online will ensure there is no duplication of driving license and the driving offenses or challans too are recorded in one place. This way both citizen and the system will be benefited. We are aware that there are malpractices prevailing in some cases when it comes to issuing of driving licenses. These portals aims to curb these by not only take the middlemen out, but also act in delivering good governance. I would like to bring to your notice that as we speak, there are 11 crore registration certificates and 3 crore driving licenses that have been digitized. Their information is available online. Continuing with the same, Ministry of Road Transport and Highways has created state and national registers. In the state registers, information from state RTOs is collected and the same is further shared with the national register. Friends, my ministry has envisaged national transport projects for computerization and interlinking of all the RTOs, DTOs across the country. I'm glad to say that 987 out of the 993 RTOs across all the 35 states and union territories have been replicated under the national register. As we set out to integrate all the data on drivers and vehicles, it is imperative that when the executive bodies, the state governments come on board. While the new licenses and registration certificates are being issued online, there is a pile of old data that needs to be digitalized. We face a daunting task of digitalizing legacy data, which is in tune of close to 6 crore driving licenses and 5 crore registration certificates. Ministry of Road Transport and Highways has initiated a scheme to provide financial assistance to the state government for digitalizing of the legacy data. We aim to have all the legacy data online by March 31, 2015. Friends, as we move forward in the digital space, it is mandatory that we ensure our digital platform are in sync with the technology changes. We must ensure that the government of data we digitalize can be integrated with data of other departments. This will help in ensure effective governance and turn making the system transparent. I am hopeful that the brainstorming of this August gathering will throw ideas that will help us achieve our goals. Dear friends, I have spoken in English, but let me say very frankly that I am keen to interact about the Hindi media because basically we are dealing with the drivers. You have to appreciate this thing that our clientele is having a socio-economic status. That socio-economic status compels us how we can popularize the IT to the drivers. Unless and until we communicate into their language, whatever intervention we are making will not have effective intervention as we expect for the good governance. So this particular transport sector is having a different kind of perception about the people. You know that the large number of driving license are just as a driving license or RTO or the functioning aid. As a citizen, not as a minister, I have seen it, that if you want to have a driving license, you're not supposed to go to the office. you are supposed to identify the correct client or correct agent linked with the transport system, and you can get the driving license. If I commit a mistake, commit a crime in one state, there's fair possibility that I can get the driving license from the other states. The number of the practices prevail at the lower level. We are aware about that the large number of the transporters who are in this business are having a different kind of background. They are basically entrepreneurs, but entrepreneurs not knowing to the IT sector. So we are introducing the IT sector to an unknown clientele area, whether he is the owner of a truck or whether owner of a bus or the driver. We have a different kind of a social profile of the people who are dealing in the transport sector. This is one area, great area. And the second concern for every citizen is about the school. जो टीनेजर्स के बच्चे हैं उनके साथ स्कूलिंग में जो गाड़ियां काम में ली जा रही है. वी हैव सीन दैट द इंसिडेंट टुक प्लेस इन दिल्ली. द इंटरेस्टिंग पार्ट इज दैट उसकी गाड़ी का लाइसेंस, ड्राइवर का, उस गाड़ी का फिटनेस और ये सब चीजें हैं वो रिवील करती है कि दिल्ली जैसी जगह में स्कूल में बच्चों का जो सर्टिफिकेशन और ड्राइविंग का लाइसेंस है वो यदि इफेक्टिव मैकेनिज्म के अंतर्गत नहीं है तो व्हाट अबाउट द रिमोट एरियाज. And that the concern that incident took place, and then suddenly entire society became awakened about this. So we have to deal this aspect also. That can we think about having the manufacturer sector to come into to the terms? The CCTV ke jo camera hum abhi tak laga rahe, can't we have the CCTV camera in the bus itself? Because large number of the young generation are going from one place to other or from residence to the institution where they have the teaching facilities by the bus. Traveling by the bus. So the other area where we have to deal very seriously, because till now we are dealing with all the transporter and all these who are contributing economic activity. Now the young generations जो है उसकी जो problem है वो ज़्यादा concern की है और insecurity parents में ज़्यादा है, because teenagers के बच्चों को bus के द्वारा school में या college में पढ़ने के लिए भेजने के बाद जिस तरह की घटनाएं आ रही है वो हमें ज़्यादा compel करती है हम इस इश्यू के संबंध में भी चर्चा करने के बात करें. नहीं, मोटर व्हीकल एक्ट बहुत पुराना, मोटर व्हीकल एक्ट के बाद जो ये कॉस्मोपोलिटन सिटी में जो ट्रांसपोर्टेशन की व्यवस्था है तेज गति से बढ़ रही है, जिस तेज गति से आने वाले समय में हमें मास रैपिड ट्रांसपोर्ट की व्यवस्था करने का काम करना पड़ेगा, ये इशू जैसे जिन इशूज के संबंध में भी हमें समय पर इशूज को एड्रेस करने के लिए तैयारी करनी चाहिए. माई ओन थिंकिंग विल बी दैट वी रिक्वायर्ड आईटी. IT can give a solution. IT is essential for transparency. IT is essential for accountability. But more than that, we have to identify the areas where the people by and large are concerned. And आज की डेट में ज्यादा कंसर्न इस बारे में है कि हम इन चीजों के संबंध में भी चर्चा करने का काम करें. As for the provision of the constitutions, the government of India ministry can give advice. The education part lies with the state government. There are certain functions to be performed by the state government. State government have to take some initiatives. This initiative will be unique from the different areas. The northeast people are having different problem, and the problem of the say south Indian will be different, and people who are traveling in the metros will be a different problem. So you cannot have the uniform solution for all the things. So you have to have the best practices prevail in different part of the country, so that we integrate the best information and then come out with this. Look, this is the solution we can propose to the society by and large. So with these words, I hope that this workshop will not only deliberate on the issues which we are confirming, but will deliberate the issues which are beyond the today's point of discussions. Because by and large, people are expecting that we have to play a role of proactive role. And proactive role can only be played when we envisage certain things. And certain things society compels us to think it, certain things we have to imagine it. And then we can think about that these are the problem solutions. I think that IT intervention gives us an opportunity where we think beyond the issues and then come out with the solution. I hope that you will deliberate on these issues. These are the some concerns which I have shown. If Mr. Pandit, you have more concern than me. This is always better that we interact together and come out with the solution. With these words, I wish that this workshop will come out with some practical and pragmatic solution. With these words, I congratulate my officials, particularly Mr. Chibba, Mr. Randopadhyay, and Mr. Mahesh, who took initiative in introducing IT in my ministry. Thank you.